Hey guys, welcome to my Man of Steel review. Just in case it's your first time visiting this planet and you don't know anything about Superman, this is for you. This time around, directing duties fall into the hands of Zack Snyder. Now, looking at his previous efforts, we do know at the very least we will get a visual treat, and he does tend to care about the story. Now, Christopher Nolan, director of the Batman trilogy, is serving as producer, and I imagine him imparting much of his knowledge going through that whole process three times about what a superhero film really needs to be. So with these two guys marrying on this production, I imagine that we're going to be presented with something amazing. The first thing you need to know about this particular Superman adaptation is that it's actually a science fiction film. Now, they do draw on the comic book origins and they do look at Superman 1 and Superman 2, but it also has a lot of unique selling points that I've not seen in any Superman film or series. I would also say that they've thrown in elements of War of the Worlds and Independence Day in there to make it a massive spectacular. I mean, it is an epic film. And personally, I like those touches, but I can imagine a lot of purists who didn't. The pacing and the structure of the film is done really well. I really appreciate that Zack Snyder didn't draw out the story so it took forever and ever before we actually saw any action or Superman in action. If you're used to ABC formats and you can't handle flashbacks or stories not told in chronological order at first anyway, then avoid this film because it will annoy you. Though there is some explanation in the film, if you've never read a Superman comic book before, some of the narrative, just a little bit, might be lost on you in reference to the Kryptonian state of mind. It's only a little thing and it won't ruin your viewing pleasure, so I wouldn't let that hinder you, but you could go and do some research on Kryptonian scientists now before you see the film, if you haven't already. And if you have, do it anyway. Yeah! Oh, Wing Chun! All the actors do a good job. I was especially happy with the portrayal of Lois Lane because in recent years we haven't had a really good Lois Lane. Henry Cavill does a good job as Superman. He grounds him. He makes him very human, which is what we needed to see. Don't forget that the bumbling Clark Kent version that we saw Christopher Reeves do is the only version that exists. If you watch any other Superman product, whether it's the cartoons, the films, or the comic books themselves, he's not bumbling. He's kind of strong and forthright, but not in such a manner that you would know that he was Superman. So his portrayal was really good. Michael Shannon was good as General Zod. He was a bit more brash and loud than everybody else, but he needed to be that because he's the villain. But check out his lieutenant. I'm not going to say who she was. If you're versed in Superman mythology and characters, you'll be happy to see her, and she was brilliant. Really good character. But you'll have to watch the film. The supporting cast, Kevin Costner, Diane Lane, Lawrence Fishburne, and everybody, they were just very calm and very grounded, and that made it more realistic. I have been saying for ages and ages and ages that the action sequences that happen in the cartoons that DC release on a regular basis need to start happening in the films, and this is the first Superman film where it really happens. If you've seen Batman, Superman, Public Enemies, or Doomsday, or Apocalypse, finally we have action on screen with real human beings that can match the cartoons, and it's very epic. If you're not into that, you're gonna hate it, but if you are, it looks really good. It's done really well. And Man of Steel is the first one that actually does that. They came close in Avengers, they did have some stuff in there, but this is absolutely epic. I mean, this is a boxing match where when someone gets smacked down, they go through a building and another building, and buildings are collapsing all over. There's a lot of collapsing buildings in this film, but it's good, and I'm really happy that they actually finally have done that. This will set a precedent for all the superhero films to come where you have mighty characters, because that's how it goes down. Yeah! Now, I was going to give this film an 8 out of 10, but I'm going to boost it up to a 9 because the beginning grabbed me so hard that I actually wanted to see a prequel with Jor-El. Before Superman even gets on the scene, what Jor-El does, played by Russell Crowe, is fantastic. That whole segment, that could have been a short film, and if you didn't see anything else to do with Superman, you would have been happy with that. That's how good it was. For me. You. Yeah. Now, this is a warning, okay? This Superman adaptation is not going to be liked by all, so I'm going to try and help some of the people that I don't think will like it. First of all, if you do not like science fiction, do not watch this film. If you think Iron Man 2 and Iron Man 3 are good, do not watch this film. If you hate watching massive epic fights, do not watch this film. If you want to see a bumbling Clark Kent that, you know, the Christopher Reeve, that Christopher Reeves did really well, that was his version, cool. But that's not what this is. It's 2013, it's time to move along. What else? I'm trying to think. Basically, all the elements that exist in science fiction that put people off, it's in there. You know, it's not too technical, but you know, if you don't like science fiction, just leave it. So thumbs up, yes. Sitting there thinking they need to make a prequel with Jor-El. Russell Crowe was brilliant. That whole opening segment with Russell Crowe before Superman is even sent to Earth is so good that if I'm thinking they need to make a prequel about him, then you know the opening was good. Some people will probably disagree, but you know, some people voted for Conservatives, so you can't please everybody.